So I'd like to take a little bit of time now to see if we can look at a few of these cool extensions that have been made already. And I'm really happy to be able to introduce somebody that that we've been working with closely in the community from pretty early on. So Colin from Xmarks, come on up and let's see your extension. Sure.
Thanks, guys. I'm Colin. I'm here with Will. We're software developers for Xmarks. Our main product is a cross-browser extension that synchronizes your bookmarks between different computers and browsers. And we're happy to be here today talking about one of our more recent projects, Xmarks for Chrome. We'll start with just a quick demo of Xmarks in action. You can access our main UI from the Xmarks icon on the top right. As you can see, we're currently synchronizing successfully. And from this page, we can also access some of our other local settings. Xmarks icon also gives us a shortcut to my.xmarks.com. This website gives you online access to your bookmarks from any computer, as well as some of our more advanced online features. And since we're already synchronizing, you can see the bookmarks in this browser match up with what you see here in the bookmark bar for Chrome. So to show Xmarks in action, Will's actually going to delete one of these bookmarks on our website. That means the next time we sync in Chrome, that deletion will come down and we'll remove it in Chrome too. So if you go to the Xmarks icon and hit synchronize now, we'll get that synchronized go, and when it finishes, that bookmark should also get removed from Chrome. And it's taken a little second. There you go, the bookmark's gone there too. Similarly, if we were to add a bookmark in Chrome or move things around and then synchronize after that, that change will go back to our servers and from there out to any other computers and browsers running Xmarks. As a software developer, there are a couple of things I'm excited about in Chrome. The first is that everything is written in HTML and JavaScript. This makes it really easy for us to port over our existing extensions. Xmarks, for example, has a lot of client-side code, and we were able to port pretty much all of our core sync code to Chrome without any changes at all. And we didn't just happen to get lucky in this one case. A couple weeks ago, I was looking at search tabs. This is another Xmarks extension that helps users discover similar sites while they're searching. I got it up and running in Chrome in less than a day, and it was something like 50 Chrome-specific lines of code. Everything else was shared cross-browser code. This is a huge win for us, and not just because we get things up and running so fast. More importantly for me, it means that maintaining that code and those extensions is going to be a lot more manageable for us in the future. The second thing I'm excited about is that the extension API has access to HTML5 features. When I first started working on Xmarks for Chrome, one of the biggest issues I had was figuring out how to sort information on the user's computer. We store a lot of data locally to help speed up our sync process, but the extension API doesn't really have any file I/O code or support. However, HTML5 has things like it's got local storage and SQL databases. And so I was able to take our file I/O code and rewrite that using these HTML5 features, and everything else runs smoothly on top of that. Overall, I'm pretty excited to be writing extensions for Chrome. I think that the extension API itself really promotes cross-browser development, and that's going to make it a lot easier for us to build and maintain our extensions. So thanks again, guys. And up next, I think we've got Jeff talking about Google Translate.
Hi. I'm Jeff from the Google Translate team. But before I begin, I wanted to just give a quick shout out to Jerry Tang, the engineer who developed the Translate extension. Unfortunately, he couldn't be here, so I'll be giving the demo instead. So let's say you're searching for the top French news stories and start by going to google.fr. Since the content of this page is in French, but my browser language is in English, the Translate extension will pop up and prompt me to see whether or not I want to translate this page into English. Since I don't speak French, I'll go ahead and click on Translate, and voila. The page is now instantly translated into English so I can read and understand it. So now I'm looking for news, so now I'm able to find news since it's in my language. I'll go ahead and click on the news link. And since this next page is also in French, the Translate extension will immediately translate the page as well. So if the Translate extension looks similar or the same as the website translator gadget that's on Google Translate, well, the reason why is because it's the same code. Developing the Translate extension was quick and easy because we were able to leverage the existing code that we've created. In order to reuse this code, though, we proposed two functions to the extensions API. The first one, detect language, automatically detects the language of the page and returns it to us. We use this to determine whether or not we should prompt and show this banner to the user to translate the page. The second function, execute script, allows us to inject our existing gadget code into the page and tell the browser to execute it. So in summary, developing the Translate extension for Chrome was extremely easy and quick because we were able to reuse and leverage existing code. And if there's a function that you need that doesn't yet exist, you can propose it to the Chrome team. And once approved, you can work with them to get it implemented. And next, Adam from eBay will share with you his experience.
Thanks. It's great to be here. You know, it's been a long time since we've thought of eBay as just a website. Ever since we first launched our public APIs in 2000, we really viewed eBay as an e-commerce platform where our customers can buy and sell wherever they are, really creating a new and much more robust site than what we had before. And we sort of call this policy eBay Anywhere. We want our customers, whether they're using a mobile device, whether on eBay.com, whether they're using a desktop gadget, to experience eBay wherever they are. And that's why development environments such as Google Chrome are so important to us, because we know that many of our customers do use Chrome, and we want them to have a fantastic experience when they do so. Now I'm going to give a quick demo of an extension that one of our team has been working on. Just like the Translate team, they unfortunately couldn't be here today because they're in London, but I'm going to do the demo on their behalf. So again, it doesn't matter. You could be on a page, you know, searching news.google.fr, and you say, hey, I want to check to see what's going on eBay. And so we have a menu right here that you can go and click and find out what's going on. And I've already signed in, so you can see I'm sort of watching a couple items, Lego Star Wars, new sneakers. And I'm going to say, oh, maybe I want to get that, you know, but why need more information? You know, you can sort of click, see more, and sort of does a nice little fade and moves over, and you can see all the information you want to know about the item. Or, and actually, if you want to, you can go and place more, go and actually place the bid. Alternatively, this is sort of what we call our My eBay interface, and so those are our active items. We also have ended items, right? These are all the things that I've been watching or buying or lost. And if I say, hey, I want to try to find out, hey, what was that item that I just won? Well, then I can just sort of click here, pull up a little menu, and do a filter in place just to find the item that I won, and there it appears, right? So now it's changed, so instead of leave a bid, to leave feedback. So everything's sort of in context, in place, really easy to filter it. Of course, we also have the ubiquitous search box, so I could look for kittens, for example, but you know, we actually have a policy. You can't sell kittens on eBay, so so I won't do that, because Lord knows what might show up. Sorry. Do it yourself. Anyway, so once again, we really enjoyed, it was a really fun experience writing the extension. The integrated development environment, which you sort of saw earlier, made it much easier for us to build and debug it. Also, we have existing extensions that were written for other browsers, and similar to what you also, again, heard before, it was very easy for us to port over our code. All the business logic just went straight over, and then when we had to go and tackle the UI, that we just had to do that for Chrome, and that made, again, keeping all of our code bases in sync nice and easy. In fact, that's one of the things that we really took advantage of when doing the design with HTML5 and CSS3 to do what we really wanted, because Chrome has a different approach, as you learned, a more minimalist approach to user interface, and we had to figure out how do we tackle that problem, you know, while remaining webby and also eBay. And so it was really great, sort of thinking about how to handle it, and ultimately went with a sort of a mobile approach because they both have, in some ways, a restrained real estate and small UI that needs to get done. And so when we tackled that, we said, hey, we can take advantage of CSS3 to do rounded corners and gradients for the background, things that we had done before, but we had to put image hacks and things that we didn't like. So this was much cleaner and really simplified our presentation logic. Likewise, with HTML5, we were able to go much more beyond the fact that we have cookies, right? So with eBay, there's a lot of user preferences. There's a lot of data for each of the items that you could be watching, up to 200. In this case, we were able to use the name value pair database for all of our preferences. We were able to use the SQLite database to store all the items. It made it very easy for us to really keep all the information right here and improve the speed and efficiency, which is, again, something that we really want to make sure our customers experience. So overall, we really had a fantastic time working with the Chrome team, and really want to thank them for all the support that they've given us. The best part from our standpoint is when we built this extension, everything we saw here, those are our public APIs. We didn't have to make any changes to our own APIs to implement this. So any developer, whether it's eBay or anyone in this room or anywhere on the internet, can go and build that right now. And so we really hope that developers will see this as a great opportunity for them to use Chrome as a platform to extend and create fantastic extensions for our community. So if anyone you want to talk to me, I'll be out here later. And so now I'm going to turn it over to Nick from Google.